moi, j'ai rien à me reprocher pour le moment. Hein. J'ai vu avec mes hommes de coin, avec Nasser, Marcel et Yalim. Bon, de toute façon, on s'attendait à un combat dur. Hein. Kessler, c'est que 14 mois qu'il s'est arrêté. 14 mois, c'est rien dans une carrière. Donc, bon, il a. On savait que c'est. Ouais.
Otherwise, I will be lost. No, I have nothing to blame myself. I talked with my corner guy, corner man. It's clear that we knew that it would be a tough fight, and it proved to be. And Mikael, of course, we said something different at the press conference for obvious reasons, but 14 months layoff is not that long for a fighter of that class.
Donc bon, 14 mois c'est rien, moi je me suis dit 14 mois sans boxer ça pouvait être une chance à jouer. Voilà, bon maintenant je sais ce que c'est la classe mondiale. Voilà donc bon,
bah,
on va retourner à l'école.
I thought that after 14 months that might give me a chance. It proved that it was not enough. I have nothing to regret in any way. We see what is the top world class, and no problem. We go back to school.
Thank you very much. Let's ask his coach, Nasser. Nasser, how do you rate the performance of Mehdi tonight? Obviously, he deserves a lot of credit for getting back up and coming at Mikkel. How did you see this fight going tonight?
Bon, moi je pense que avec Mehdi puis toute l'équipe, hein, il y a aussi Marcel qui est là et Alim. Je pense qu'avec Mehdi, toute l'équipe, Monsieur Ross, on est loin d'être des imbéciles. On savait qu'on s'attaquait à un gros morceau. On voulait situer Mehdi par rapport à ce gros morceau. Et ben comme dit Mehdi, il faut retourner à l'école et puis apprendre encore et encore. Voilà, déjà ça.
He will finish his answer. First of all, it's a teamwork. He is thanking members of his team, of our team, Marcel Denis, who is very well known in France, and Alim Chalabi, and he was thanking me. Thank you very much. We are not stupid people. We knew very well that it would be a very high mountain to climb. It was a challenge, but we wanted to really see how Mehdi is positioned vis-à-vis this megastar like Mikkel. No problem, we go back to school, we learn a lot, and I would add, and of course he will say himself, but don't forget that Mehdi has only half the number of fights that Mikkel has.
Alors, pour parler du combat en lui-même, ben, dès le premier round, on a vu les lacunes, mais surtout les points forts de Mikkel Kessler. On savait que ça serait très dur. Mehdi, à chaque fois qu'il s'est fait toucher, il est revenu pour essayer de repartir plus fort. Mais Kessler, il a du métier. Quand il a touché, ben, il finit. Et il a bien boxé contre Mehdi. Il a fait ce qu'il fallait. Mehdi n'a rien à se reprocher. Voilà, il a fait ce qu'il pouvait.
We have seen from the first round the weaknesses of Mikkel, but particularly his strength. And he has a lot of experience. When he is hitting somebody, he knows how to continue his performance just to go to the end. We have nothing to regret in any way. Clearly, Mikkel is a great champion, we know that. And in this kind of fight, you progress a lot. That's a way to move to the next step. And don't forget, Mehdi, we just had a discussion between ourselves and we took an immediate decision we would move down to the middleweight division.
Thank you very much. Thanks for translating, Bernard. Now we could hear your take on the fight and also your assessment of Mehdi's future. If you, first of all, let's welcome the Viking Warrior, Mikkel, and his promoter, Kalle Sauerland, and Patrick as well, Patrick Nielsen. And Jimmy should be here as well.
Where's Jimmy? Jimmy and a chair.
We have a chair here.
Ah, you have a chair.
Oh, yeah.
everyone is Jimmy Horn.
Can you try and get him? Perhaps
he's taking a shower.
Before responding to Johannes, let me first of all, in the name of Mehdi, in the name of the team, congratulate again Mikel for his performance. Boxing needs people like him, being a great champion in the ring and outside of the ring. He delivers a great image. We are very proud that we have been able to fight a champion like this. And we thank Silent Events to give us such an opportunity. That's what I wanted to say. But now to respond to the question is, a promoter needs to always have several plans in drawer. Of course, we had great hope to be able to create a great surprise, and we are pretty confident. And I know that Mikel is also a guy who can say the truth, and I think in the fourth round, the combination of a few left hook made him for a very short while a little in danger. I think that's very encouraging for Mehdi, which is a proof that when he moved down to the middleweight division and with a little bit more of experience, and maybe Mikel will give us a chance maybe to come to help him to prepare some other fights, which is a way for Mehdi to get an additional experience, because he needs experience. We see that how Mikel is able to let us do exactly what we wanted to avoid, which was to go to his right hand. And it's nice to have a plan, but when you don't have the full experience, and when you have a guy who is pushing you exactly the opposite way, in fact, you end up by being where you should not be. And that's what we call the super class, world class, and also experience. And Mehdi doesn't have this experience. But as you have seen, if in the U.S. we from time to time call people chicken or coward, he's not a chicken. He has a cowardness of Spanish bulls.
So we're also joined now by Jimmy Montoya, and also I forgot to introduce Chris Meyer, the general manager of Team Sauerland. But now let's welcome back Mikel Kessler. Mikel, congratulations on a great victory. It looked like you've never been away. What was it like to be back?
It was very good to be back after 14 months. He was a very, very hard fighter. I don't think that I was under pressure in the fourth round, but of course I had to take a little break because I thought I had him in the second round, so I pushed myself too much, and that's why I had to take a little break in the fourth round.
Were you surprised how many shots he could take?
Yes, he could take a shot. I would like to see the doping test after. No, I just a joke. No, of course, he was very good. He was a hard fighter. He took many punches, and as his promoter said, he tried to get into the fight. I didn't let him, but he was a very tough fighter, and I punched a lot, and he was actually very good. But it would have been a different fight if I had let him in, but I didn't.
Congratulations also to Jimmy Montoya. Jimmy, your second fight with Mikel in charge, second victory. How happy are you with his performance tonight?
Well, I was very, very proud of Mikel tonight because he did almost exactly what he had to do. You know, he came around with the right punches. He put the guy in the position to use the punches, especially a 45 and the right and left hooks. And he never got too excited. He was just very calm. When he got to the corner, I would give instructions. He'd take it all, and he'd do what I told him to do, and then he'd do what he was supposed to do while we opened the guy. He never just did things crazy. He just did the things that he saw that he could do. So, Mikel, congratulations.
Thank you.
So the coach is happy, and I guess the promoter, Kalle, you're happy as well.
Good morning. First of all, I'd like to note, first of all, congratulations on a very tough performance, but I've never seen anyone take so many punches and look so good after a fight. So, congratulations. It looks like you haven't been in a fight tonight, so that's incredible. Hats off to you. You know, I expected the first two, three, even four rounds. You know, I've always compared Mikkel to a Rolls Royce. You know, if you don't drive a Rolls Royce for a year, you know, you expect it to maybe the battery doesn't work at the beginning. But no, it was definitely working. Congratulations also to Jimmy for getting him into this shape. I felt, you know, the combinations were there, as in the Frotch fight. We promised a very tough opponent. You know, he's not ranked number five in the world for nothing. I know there were some people also in this room who were making out that maybe this was a lesser opponent. Well, this is a guy, you know, who's also gone eight rounds with Gennady Golovkin, who took him to points. Golovkin is one of the biggest punchers, pound for pound. So we knew what Wilder would bring to the ring. And tonight, Mikkel had everything to deal with it. I didn't let him into the fight. And, you know, it's great to have the Viking warrior back.
So we have the real Mikkel Kessler sitting on Kalle's right, and we have maybe the next Mikkel Kessler sitting on his left. Patrick, also congratulations to you. It was an exciting fight and a great victory. What was it like for you to fight here in Copenhagen with such a great crowd? And you can answer in Danish if you like, but as you please.
Det var en kæmpe oplevelse at få lov til at kæmpe i parken. Der var så mange mennesker, og ja, det var rigtig fed stemning, da jeg gik ind, selvom jeg bare er Patrick Nielsen, så det var jeg rigtig glad for at tage med mig.
When did you know, or when were you sure of success tonight? When were you sure that you would win this fight?
Jeg var rimelig sikker på, at jeg havde kampen i min hånd i anden omgang, da jeg fik ham ned. Der følte jeg ligesom, jeg havde overtaget, og så det styrkede selvtilliden og gav mig lidt flere kræfter til at fortsætte i det tempo, så det var jeg glad for.
Thanks for that, and let's hear from Chris Meyer what he thinks from a, well, company point of view, from Team Sauerland, of this great night at Parken.
Well, look, the organization today was fabulous. The venue did a very great job in setting up together with TV2.
The arena today was incredible to watch, incredible to be here. I've never seen something here before, especially not the very old fights Mikkel had here with a certain other promoter of the past. And it's a great step forward. We are very happy to be with these two groups and work with them. The audience, I have to say as well, was a perfect day. The whole day was perfect. The people, I think, were all celebrating already today that Mikkel was coming back. And I had the feeling that whole of Copenhagen was here to continue the celebrations, and they celebrated Mikkel, and it was a fabulous crowd here today, and I think gave you also a little bit support. So thanks again.
Hello. Just had to really follow on to that. I don't want to keep you too long, but I would like to say a few things about the event in general, because I've just complimented Mikkel on a great performance, but generally, the event tonight was a big challenge for us to put something on in this space of time. It wasn't a secret that we didn't know it before. It was really, you know, 5 weeks ago that we sat down with Lottie Reimer, the CEOs, and her team have done a great job to get the event on in this time. We're more than delighted on this weekend to have a crowd of, I think, just under 13,000 in there, which is sensational. If I consider the weather and the fact that there's doesn't seem to be any Danes in Copenhagen this weekend. So, but apart from that, I would like to say a few words about the man on my left as well. He's a product of the Fight Night series. You know, if you look at Danish boxing, the two big fights this year so far have been Brian Nielsen and Mikkel Kessler. If you look 10 years ago, it was Brian Nielsen and Mikkel Kessler. So, you know, something's gone wrong in this time. I'm not saying that we're the messiah, but we're trying to make things right, and I think Patrick is the first product that is coming out of the Fight Night series, and you're going to see a lot more of this guy. And you know, he's going to do us proud, and he's going to do Denmark proud. But again, thank you very much to our partners, TV2, and also very much to Park and for Anotti for the absolute great personal touch. And we look forward to coming back.
And with that, we take your questions, please.
Kelly, what would be the next step for Mika?
A holiday. after holiday. We have plans. I mean, you know, I think I've spoken to almost every journalist in the room about the plans, but if they haven't changed since before the fight, it's, you know, it looks like Chris can talk about the WBO situation in a moment. We'll most likely be mandatory challenger now to Robert Stieglitz, which makes running no more an option. But I don't accuse Stieglitz of running, but maybe there were some political things in the past that haven't made the fight possible. Bute remains an option. We will discuss that this week as well. They've got ideas, we've got ideas. You know, I said we would love to do the next show in Denmark again. You know, but it's all a little bit of a question of what happens in the next few days. There's a fight taking place in 3.5 hours. You know, Frotch loses. You know, I know Carl would love a rematch. I'm not saying he's going to get one. But you know, there's lots and lots of options. But I would say definitely we want to go for a belt, and that's the next plan.
So next to Bute, next to possible Frotch or whoever, out of the Super 6 tournament, we will this week apply for a number one mandatory rating of by the WBO, and we will give this our application will then be considered perhaps and will be voted on. I think Mikkel will get a prominent spot in the WBO, and when he becomes mandatory contender, then I think we get have then the option to fight Robert Stieglitz very soon, because he has not done his mandatory for more than a year. So I think if it's not Bute, I think we have a good chance to fight for a world title with the WBO. Other questions?
Yeah. Mikkel, er der nogen gode i morgen? Nej. Gudskelov, nej. Det, de vil ikke, ja, det har der været lidt snak om, de vil ikke 100% hele, jo, men 99%, men det er, det er gået rigtig godt i dag, og også efter kampen, og jeg bliver også ramt lidt i dag, så det er jeg i hvert fald glad for, men det er også mere sparring op til kampen, som har været der, hvor jeg har fået testet dem, og det er gået rigtig godt. Så dejligt, at man ikke skulle i 12 omgange i hvert fald. Så det synes jeg har gjort lidt for meget her på det sidste.
Chris, if you get the rights for the WBO title fight with the Stieglitz, will it default in Denmark then? And what are the chances of any of Mikkel's future fights being shown on ARD?
Well, look, it depends a little bit. When this situation is coming, that's an if clause, conditional clause, then we will sit down and see whether Mr. Steinfeld will now reply to an offer. And if he doesn't, or if it is not enough that we are bidding, then we go to Kursplit and then we see. Kalle would have to comment, but if we're not pay-per-view, then we are on public, on free. Receivable television, and then of course the German transmission can be done as well. Robert Stieglitz is not the biggest fighter in Germany, so it's a question of where in combination we get the most money to make this fight possible. So if we have control about the date and everything, I think we have another advantage, and I think Mikkel is a Danish fighter, and Danish fighters must fight on Danish soil.
Just so really quickly, just regarding TV, we've left everything free because every fight is a different circumstance, and at the moment there's no decision on pay-per-view or free-to-air.
Yeah, I want to know, Mikkel, when will you be ready to fight again? And of those two mentioned, who would you want to meet?
I don't care who I fight. I'll just be ready for a title fight, of course. Because when you've been out for a long time, you have to step the ladder. And you have to fight just back in. And in the Super 6, I lost the fight, but I was so lucky that I could fight a world champion right after my fight. So, but I'm out of the Super 6, so now I just hope for a title fight, as we talked about. So now I just want a vacation and want to fight in September or October. I will feel ready there, but I have to talk to my promoters about it.
If there are no further questions, I think we can just go on for the one-on-ones afterwards. Just for the record, I think the official attendance was 12,500. And we hope to see you all at the next TV2 Fight Night in Herning on September the 3rd. And with that, I wish you all a very good night. Thank you very much for joining us. Bye-bye.